one to possibly one of our stranger experiences inside a football ground. We'll try not to belabour the point too much during the afternoon, but it does feel very strange to be sitting in position on the opening day of the season and the attendance is, well, about 50, and it's journalists and stewards and medical personnel and so forth because of everything that's been going on. But it is a relief to get back to football. Hope wherever you are in the world, you're keeping safe and well. But we hope that we can be a welcome distraction for the next couple of hours or so, and hopefully a bit of progress for Plymouth Argyle in the Carabao Cup. Doesn't always happen, but the last 2 years the Pilgrims have managed to get through to the next round. The Queen's Park Rangers team are on the pitch in front of us. It's not quite the same theatrics of everyone coming out through the tunnels these days because of how things have got to be, and it is a bit of a strange atmosphere, isn't it, Brian McGlinchey?
Yeah, I think we do miss the Green Army. I think that would make a massive difference to the players, and the players would love them to be here, and it does make a difference. It gives you that extra couple of yards, that extra bit of intensity, to be fair. But the pitch looks absolutely beautiful. The sun's just come out as well. So again, as I just said earlier, this is about getting a bit of fitness, confidence, and hopefully you can get a result today and then, you know, get a bit of a run in the cup, because that will give them great confidence.
Yeah, it's a slightly strange start to the season, beginning with a Carabao Cup tie on a Saturday lunchtime, but as we said before, unprecedented times, we've got to expect these sorts of things. Not the first time, however, that we have begun with a League Cup game. It was, I believe, about 8 years ago or so, the first game of the season. It was a Tuesday night against Portsmouth, and Argyle won 3-0 on that day. Portsmouth were a little bit depleted, they were very much in their own troubles at the time, but Argyle do have history of kicking off the season with a League Cup victory, so that might stand us in good stead. As far as Rangers go, Brian, I would imagine this wouldn't have been their ideal draw in the FA Cup, not only to travel a little bit down to Plymouth, but also I would imagine you don't really want to go away to a team that's just been promoted. They've got a bit of momentum behind them.
Yeah, well, you could say that, but I think with the sort of 5-6 month window that we've had off, that maybe sort of take that sort of advantage away, I guess. I think it's, you're right. You wouldn't want to come down to Plymouth. Plymouth's always a difficult place to go. You know, there's the travelling aspect to it in these difficult times as well. And, you know, Argyle are good football inside. You know, under Ryan Lowe, they've definitely impressed me the way they knock the ball around. Obviously they'll have confidence. They're a champion side coming down to League One, but it's not easy when you come down the leagues to play, you know, against League One, League Two teams. So they'll have a difficult afternoon, I believe, here. But we're interested to see how it sort of pans out in the end.
But it's an interesting point you make about the style of play. You said about wanting to get the ball down and play. Well, I think both teams have got a bit of an ethos, haven't they, from starting from their manager, that they want to play a particular way, get the ball down. So you feel like this should be an entertaining game of football played in the right kind of way, because both of these managers will want to outpass the other one.
Yeah, definitely. It's definitely, that's what Ryan Lowe's sort of style is. He wants to play from the back and make sure they build, and because they haven't got those types of players that they can knock it up the front man and play from there under different previous Argyle managers that played that way. But this is definitely, you know, playing from the back, and Warburton's the same under QPR. So I think it'd be a really good sort of good game to watch, good football game, good players out there. The pitch looks absolutely perfect for that sort of style of football as well. So yeah, I'm just sort of lucky to be here watching it sort of live myself, so really looking forward to watching it.
Yes, we're just going through the not quite all the usual festivities before the game. No lineup, no huddles that I have seen anyway. And we're about to get ourselves underway. The referee is Anthony Coggins, and he's done the toss. The kickoff is going to be taken by Queen's Park Rangers, who are in their all blue and white stripes, blue and white hoops, I should say. Let's get that correct. And they kick us off. They are playing towards the Devonport end in the first half. Argyle towards the Bar Park end, which means all is somewhat right with the world. Well, some of it is anyway. Rangers knock it down the line, and early on it's knocked out for a throw-in by Will Ameson. So the first thing to note is that Argyle's back three. We knew they'd be playing a back three, but it looks like it'll be Ameson of the right of the three, Scott Wootton in the middle, and Kel Watts on the left-hand side in front of the goalkeeper, Michael Cooper. We'll go through the whole team for you in just a second. As Rangers throw it down the line, it's time for them to get the low cross in, and it be blocked behind for a corner by Wootton. So inside the first 30-odd seconds here, Rangers have a corner. It'll just give us a chance to give you the Argyle team. So it's Michael Cooper in goal, Ameson, Wootton and Watts at the back three, as we said. And then we've got Joe Edwards and George Cooper as wing-backs, Lewis McLeod, Connor Grant and Danny Mayer in the central midfield, with Ryan Hardy and Frank Nublé up front. We'll do the Queen's Park Rangers team in just a second. They have a corner from the left-hand side. I believe it's Elias Chair to take it. Whips it in towards the centre of the head, and it's in. We are 67 minutes into the season, and Queen's Park Rangers have taken the lead. The cross came in from the left-hand side. And I'm just trying to get a good grip on exactly who it was that headed the ball in, because the Rangers' numbers are not easy to see on their backs. I think it was their skipper, Dominic Ball. Waiting for a bit of a clarification. Ryan Manning has been given to. So Ryan Manning scores. That's not the start we were looking for, Brian.
No, not at all. It's just a corner. It's no simple set piece. Just, you know, no marking in the box at all. Sitting. It was a good header into the far corner. But yeah, you know, for me, just no marking. You know, that's just pure rustiness, you know, for me from the start. So not an ideal start for Argyle. You know, my 2-1 sort of scoreline prediction still could be okay, but not a good start for Argyle.
No, it wasn't. That's absolutely not how the script has been set over the last 6 months or so. I suppose there is a, looking completely on the bright side, there's a theory of if it's going to happen, get it out of the way early on and respond. But QPR are bombing forward again here, the cross from the right-hand side. This time, the delivery was not quite as good, leaning back. And it goes out for a goal kick, which might just give Argyle a second or two just to try and regroup here.
Yeah, sometimes I'm hoping you can score too early and become relaxed, and then Argyle can sort of get a good sort of footprint on the game, really. But yeah, not an ideal start.
Kick taken by Cooper towards Joe Edwards. And he was just seen off the ball there by Manning, and it goes out for a Rangers throw. Manning is going to try and look to go down the line. Some movement in front of him, throws it inside towards Oti. He sends it all the way back to Rob Dickey, who is a new signing, central defender from Oxford. It's down the right hand side with Rangers coming across all the way to Manning. Some confidence boosting early touches here for the visitors. Not that they need too much confidence having taken such an early lead. Now Chair gets it around the corner to Asai Samuel, just inside the area on the left hand side, cuts in, tries to square it, and in the end didn't really pick out anyone in particular, and Argyle can clear eventually. But some more nervy moments there as Rangers look to get in again. They're going to try it down the right hand side once more. I think Argyle should see this one away with Watts, but there was nearly another opening there for QPR.
Yeah, it's twice now down the left-hand side that they've been sort of done, Argyle. You know, I think Joe Edwards, you know, he's not a natural sort of right-wing back, and, you know, he's more of a centre midfielder type thing, so he's been caught there twice. But when you're playing wing-back, you can get exposed when they've got sort of two men down that left side, so that's something for Argyle to sort of keep an eye on.
Here's Argyle with the ball really for the first time, getting it wide to the right-hand side. It was Mayer that found Edwards. Now he's got a run in front of him from Hardy. It was a bit of a dummy run, and he tried to go the opposite way to Newblay, but that ball was intercepted. QPR have it along their back four, just playing it towards the left. It'll probably give us a good chance to do the QPR team. They've got Joe Lumley in goal. Their right back is Osman Kakai. Left-hand side, Ryan Manning. I'll break off because QPR again get into the area. Wouldn't have to put out a good foot to get that away on the edge of the six-yard area. And now Cooper, the first time we've really seen him. George Cooper gives the ball away with a square ball. And it falls to Mayer, and Argyle should be able to bring this away. This is Conor Grant. They'll just be happy to try and get their foot on this, won't they, Brian, just to get a few touches here.
Yeah, right?
This is not settled in the first five minutes.
No, QPR sort of settled far, far better. They're getting the ball down, and Argyle needs to get a few passes together, get their confidence. That's a better bit of play by Argyle, moving from the ball from right to left. Just keeping the ball simple now would be a good thing to do, just to, let's say, get them into the game slowly and give them a bit of confidence.
Yeah, the whole time Brian was speaking there, Argyle have kept the ball, which is nice to see. Haven't gone anywhere, but they've at least kept it and got some confidence boosting touches. It's now with Michael Cooper in the Pilgrims goal. He's just taking his time looking for a target. Perhaps it'll be Nublé, the new man. He's about 6'2", 6'3", so he could be a target for things like that. The ball has gone out of play on Argyle's right. QPR won a foul from Edwards on Manning. They're not going to get it. Edwards takes a throw. Nublé back to Ameson, inside to Conor Grant, and some more confident touches. Nice to see. Wooden brings it out from the back. Now McLeod round the corner looking for the run of Hardy. Wasn't a million miles away from finding the striker's run. And the ball is given away by Dickey to McLeod, and then into Hardy. He's tripped on the edge of the box, is he? Yes, he is, according to the referee. So Argyle will have their first sight on goal, you would think. Just outside the box, good chance here, perhaps.
Yeah, good play by McLeod, good pass. Definite free kick. The linesman didn't give it, but the referee definitely did. So a good chance, ideal for Cooper with your left foot here, maybe.
It's going to be, let's see who's over it. It's George Cooper, perhaps favourite, with Lewis McLeod alongside him. Could be two options here. Could be a little floated ball in, or it could be a shot on goal. I would think, though, George Cooper will have his sights set on trying to get himself back on the Argyle score sheet early on, since returning during the week. So here we go, free kick about to be taken. It's Coops against the hoops. We're waiting for the referee's signal. Cooper steps up, left footed, curls it. Oh, it's off the post! It is off the post. Did the keeper get a hand to it? I'm not quite sure, but it struck the woodwork. Argyle still have it. Hardy on the left-hand side. Gets the cross in. It's come off Watts. It's still not cleared by QPR. Will it fall to Cooper again? Not quite. And eventually, I think Rangers are going to be able to get this ball away, just about anyway, far enough to McLeod, who can head it back in. And now Mayer trying to wriggle free on the left-hand side. It fell away, and it will be a QPR throw-in. What a chance that was. What a strike.
Oh, amazing, amazing effort. The keeper had no chance. Keeper wasn't getting there. It was just a little bit more to the left-hand side. Great, great strike. Hit the post. That will give Cooper confidence as well. You can just see already the quality of that guy. So hopefully he'll do that throughout the season and create more chances for Argyle.
Chair with the ball for QPR, and then sent left to right from Manning. Picked up on the right-hand side by Oti. And then a collision between the overlapping fullback Kakai and Kel Watts, who was covering over. And this time it'll be a QPR free kick in a good position. And while the ref is just having a chat with Watts, he'll just give us a chance to round off that Queen's Park Rangers team. So the midfield, we've got Dominic Ball in the centre of midfield with Tom Carroll and indeed Luke Amos. And then up front, it's Aramidi Ote with Bright Osai Samuel and Elias Chair. They look like they're sort of rotating the three up front, a little bit of shades of the old days with Tevez and Rooney and Ronaldo. They're not quite at that level, I would suspect, but they're going to be a danger to Argyle. Here's a free kick to be taken from the right-hand side by Chair. He delivered the corner that was headed in the first couple of minutes, and he sends it this time. This one bounces around, is headed away by two Argyle players. First Ameson, then Mayer. And Ameson again will head it partially clear. Comes back out to the left-hand side for Rangers. Manning sweeps it in from deep. George Cooper attempts to see it out. I think Chair will just about keep it in, though, right by the corner flag on the right-hand side for Rangers. Chair looking to try and stand up Cooper and beat him, but it was a bit of a standoff, so he goes to the edge of the area, and Rangers trying to build that way. Back out to Chair on the right, good feet, comes inside, and then tries to feed it to Osai Samuel, who turns and holds the ball up. Rangers being patient, that deflected back off of Kakai, and Argyle want an offside for it. Kakai still has the ball, and the linesman's flag stays down. Patient build by Rangers, and then Carroll tries to send one from the centre to the left to towards Manning, but it goes out of play.
Yeah, a bit impressed by Chair already. Just he's getting in them pockets of space, and he just seems to get on the ball and make things happen for QPR. I think McLeod's got to maybe have a look at him playing that defensive midfield sort of option. I think that was something that maybe Argyle have got to keep an eye on today.
I'm hesitant to use this term because it's perhaps a bit out of my depth in terms of technicalities, but there's some suggestion it's a bit of a false nine position that he's playing in Chair. He seems to start up front but drift into the midfield, quite hard to pick up.
Yeah, difficult mark, because you don't know where to get the centre half. Doesn't maybe want to go into those spaces, and the midfielder's got to have sort of good sort of views all around him to pick him up as well. So he's a bit elusive, and it's hard to mark, so got to keep an eye on him.
Free kick to Rangers just inside their own half. Foul given against Mayer. Rangers take it quickly and come down the left-hand side. Here is Chair that we mentioned, and as Brian mentioned, McLeod is right on him. Rangers will still keep it, although Edwards is fighting for it. Both men fall down in a heap, and in the end a free kick is given for a foul on Osai Samuel, who now has it again down the left-hand side. Two Argyle players block him off, so Rangers have to come back to Manning. And Osai Samuel again. His first name is Bright, and that is a good description of him. He's going to be a danger if he's allowed to run. Held up there, but it's come inside to Amos. Will he be able to shoot? Plays it right to Kakai. What can he do? Low ball in, and in the end, the header up in the air from Ameson, and then a good claim from Michael Cooper. There was a danger there with the ball dropping, but that was good confidence from the young goalkeeper there, Brian, to come
and
get that.
Yeah, no, I did well. That's good authority to come and collect that. Really good. To be fair, QPR started really well. They're moving the ball from right to left. and they're just moving it really, really quickly, and Argyle is struggling to sort of get close to them, especially around Argyle's 18-yard box. So maybe a difficult afternoon from what we see so far.
Yeah, they've got some good ball players, haven't they? We've already talked a lot about Elias Chair. It was interesting that he was given the number 10 shirt with the Queen's Park Rangers squad numbers during the week, and that's a big deal at Loftus Road. They've had players like Rodney Marsh and Stan Bowles over the years, and coming even a bit more up-to-date, players like Adil Tarat, even our own former Akos Buzaki. There's been a few good number 10s over the years, and they believe that to be the key number. It was Eze who departed for Crystal Palace in the summer a few weeks ago, who had that last year. So it's a big deal for KPR, that shirt, and he certainly looks like the bright spark earlier.
Moroccan international, I believe.
Born in Belgium, plays for Morocco.
Yeah, you've got to give it to me, buddy, all right?
He's a small man. I don't like to always draw that attention to too much, because what does size matter if you've got the ability? But he's diminutive, but he's quality so far from what we can see. QPR have a throw-in on the left-hand side. This is Manning, and he's going to throw it inside. It's going to be chested down. Goes back to Manning, and the tackle from McLeod was a little bit late, and I think the referee is, again, just going to have a little chat here.
Yeah, I don't think there was much in that, really. I think, you know, I think Manning just ride the challenge there, and he's going to be okay. But it's good McLeod's putting his stuff about. I think that's important when you're a midfielder. You've got to be sort of combative and make yourself known on the pitch, because when you're playing in League One, that's the type of sort of things you've got to do to get a grip in the game.
QPR take it short. There's no knocking it into the box from there. And they go down the left-hand side again. It's where a lot of their attack seems to have come from. And they try a little triangle to get the ball into the channel, but it's dealt with by Ameson, who gets it clear towards Nublé, headed down comfortably by Rangers. And Masterson will try and go back to his goalkeeper. It might be a bit short. Hardy didn't quite get there. Lumley had to be fast off his line, or not even off his line, out of his area, because the ball looked a little bit short. Just for a second there, I thought there was an opening.
Yeah, I thought Hardy was going to get there. Good pace by Hardy, but goalkeeper was definitely on his toes and got there first.
Edwards with the throw. He's the captain for Argyle this afternoon. Throws into Mayer. They try to go around the corner for McLeod, but that again is cut out. Chair tries an ambitious early ball. Didn't connect, bit of an air shot. And Michael Cooper will clear for the Pilgrims. Again, it goes up towards Nublé. Wins the flick on. Hardy is sniffing around behind. The ball back to the goalkeeper from Dickey. Is bouncing around. Again, Hardy tries to shut it down. It's easily cleared this time by Lumley, where Amos picks it up and goes back to Kaká. Inside to Tom Carroll, back at Queen's Park Rangers, only picked up in the last 24, 48 hours or so. Been around the place, Swansea, Tottenham. All forward there, headed clear by Whitten. And now Cooper, George Cooper in a little bit of a tight squeeze, but he came out of it. And Conor Grant and Kellen Watts get the ball away down the left-hand side.
QPR squeezing right up, so when Cooper got the ball there, QPR were right on his toes, not allowing Cooper to get time the ball to sort of pick a pass and see what QPR are here to do today.
You are just joining us here on BBC Radio Devon. This is Plymouth Argyle versus Queen's Park Rangers, and the visitors took a lead after 67 seconds through Ryan Manning, so Argyle are a goal down. If you are looking for Kerry White, she is on until 1 p.m. on our other frequencies, 103.4 FM countywide, on a medium wave in the Exeter area and in North Devon. You can have the Kerry White up until 1 o'clock, and then the Exeter City commentary on that frequency from 2 o'clock. But we're with you here at the moment on 95.7 and on DAB. This is BBC Radio Devon, Argyle 0, QPR 1, as they look to increase that. Chair gets into the area. Good challenge, though, from Ameson. Timed that really well and came away with the ball. Now Nublé tries to turn and get away, and he has done down the right-hand side. Can he get there before the covering Rob Dickey? He can't. Dickey just did well to keep it in. But Edwards wins it back and goes away down the right-hand side. Dickey once more in the right place. Goes back to the goalkeeper just for a second there. I thought there was going to be an Argyle breakaway, but good covering from the central defender.
Yeah, that was good defending. So Nublé did well. He sort of got round and just a bit overhead the sort of his second touch, and good defender by Masterson in the end.
Just before that, I want to point out a good tackle by Ameson as well, because it was a dangerous position from Chair getting into the area. And Ameson didn't just block it, but he committed himself to ground in the area, but he came away with the ball. It was next to the stop.
Yeah, I think when you go to ground in the box, it's dangerous, but he did very well, timed it brilliantly. And it was a good challenge, it was.
It'll be an interesting season for him in many ways, because he came in during the season last year with everybody else lots of other Bury players and was expected to be a big part of the season, and injury sort of curtailed it. Cliche is that he's like a new signing, and I don't want to say it like that, but it will feel like a bit of a fresh start for him if he's fully fit and gets to mark his card in League One.
Yeah, definitely. And he'd probably had the 4 or 5 months to say off with the pandemic to get himself fit as well, and that will help him. But he'd be sort of raring to go and making sure that he sort of gets a regular sort of fixture in the team this year. He started the game pretty well.
Argyle throw, left hand side, Cooper to Grant. George Cooper hooks it forward, looking for Ryan Hardy, who's going to get there. Indecision between the goalkeeper and the defender. So Hardy picks it up wide on the left, but there is a chance. Cuts it inside. It's going to fall to Mayer. Edge of the box. Will he shoot? Tries to tee up a chance for McLeod. Drives it. That's a fine block. Just trying to work out which Rangers player it was that threw his body on the line there. It was a very good block indeed. I think it was Manning, actually. And he heads forward as Hameson will have to try and deal with this. Goes back to his goalkeeper. Just a bit of indecision there between Rangers players. Nearly let Argyle in there, Brian.
Yeah, no, it was a fantastic block. The ball broke to Danny Mayer. And Danny Mayer, I haven't really seen him in the game at all. He sort of just laid it off. McLeod just absolutely smashed it, but it was a great block by Manning. He sort of put his life on the line to stop that.
Yeah, it's very committed defending there. And they had to make up for it there, Queen's Park Rangers. That would have been... Well, the opening goal from Argyle point of view was not a pretty one, but that would have been even worse for Rangers had they let the Pilgrims in there. They didn't in the end. Cooper, the goalkeeper, spreads it out to Kel Watts. Calmness from Michael Cooper. And now it's his namesake, George. And now Watts once again into the feet of Connor Grant. Takes it in, gets in front of his man. Still inside the Pilgrims' half, but they keep the ball well enough there under pressure from the men in the hoops. Mayer, Grant, good ball through to Cooper down the left-hand side. This is lovely football by Argyle. Crossing from Cooper, just intercepted by the first man. And now Amos is back to cover. Dickey and Amos get themselves out of a tight spot on the right-hand side and clear away. But only as far as McLeod, still inside Rangers territory. Leaves it to Connor Grant. Left-hand side, back into McLeod again. Now he's got his arms out saying, where's my support? He flips the ball over the top to Ameson. Again, still inside Rangers territory. Ameson crosses from deep, and it's a little bit too deep, the ball in. Cooper was sniffing around at the far side to try and keep the ball alive, and unfortunately it went out for a goal kick in the end.
Yeah, I think Danny Mayer is going to be crucial to get into this game. He sort of moved over to the right-hand side there to try and find a bit of space, and Ameson didn't really sort of pick him up there. Ameson went for the sort of ambitious cross in the end. But I think that's what Argyle got to do. They did that last year really well. They sort of interlinked between Cooper and Mayer, and that really, really helps when they do that.
Ball through from the back, low into the channel, looking for Asai Samuel, but really well dealt with by Scott Wootton, who brings it away calmly. And now Watts hits the left channel looking for a runner. Hardy is after it, but it's defended well enough again by Dickey. Back on out on the far side, it can. It's a throw in for Argyle, which will be taken on the left hand side by George Cooper. After a very, very bright start from Queen's Park Rangers, it does feel like we're only, what are we, just under 20 minutes into the game, but it does feel like the last 10 minutes or so Argyle have settled a bit better, Brian.
Yeah, they have. I think QPR not as sort of pressing as high up the pitch. It's given Argyle a bit more time on the ball and they're able to get a bit more confidence. But yeah, QPR have dropped off a little from their sort of really, really good start. I think Newbley's won a few balls in there as well, a few flick-ons, that's maybe helping them. But yeah, I think as the game goes on, Argyle should commend it.
It'll be interesting to see the extra dimension that he offers, won't it, really? Because I'm not saying Argyle were one-dimensional last season, that would be harsh, but there was certainly the emphasis was on getting the ball down, and there wasn't really too many in the way of what we'll call target men. But as you said already, Newbley's won 2-3 important headers. He offers something different. If you're struggling at the back, he's an out ball.
I think you can't be predictable. I think if you've got some sort of different options, it does really, really help, and it gets you up the pitch as well. You know, if you're playing in your own half and you can see QPR pressing on to Argyle, if you make a mistake there, they're on your goal, really, so it will help.
Yes, while that was going on, Newbley with rather, well, what looked a perfectly fine enough tackle to me, was given a free kick by the linesman, who, to be fair to me, is much closer than I am. So it's a free kick to Rangers inside their own half. Manning takes it short, gets it back, and then he goes long, looking for Amos, flicked on. It's going to go through to Cooper. I rather feel that the runner going through there, Ote, probably would have been offside had he picked the ball up. It matters not, because Argyle have got it. Cooper, Watts. Interesting how far up the pitch QPR are when Argyle have the ball along their back four or five.
Yeah, pressing high again now. Every time Argyle got the ball, there was someone on the first touch.
Down the left-hand side again goes Osai Samuel inside the area again. Ameson thinks about going to ground this time, thought better of it. Osai Samuel back to Carroll. And now Chair is pulled out to the left-hand side. Good little triangle by Rangers again. Carroll comes inside. Chair, 25 yards out, thinks about shooting, tries to play it through. Good anticipation from Grant. And he manages now to bring it away with a couple of 1-2s. My instinct is still to say Connor Grant every time he gets it, because there's been so many Grants here in the past. Now there's just the one. He's played it through, though, and it's Mayer. He's now one-on-one on the left-hand side. Comes inside. Will he be able to shoot from about 12 yards? Does so. A good charge down by Dickey. And Rangers are away. They left themselves exposed there against Mayer. And now we'll come back to that in a second, because Rangers go forward. Ameson has failed to get it in front of Osai Samuel, who goes past him, comes inside and tries to tee up the shot for Oti inside the area. Watts blocks it. It will go trickling out, I think, for a Rangers throw on the right-hand side. Chances at both ends, Brian.
Yeah, no, great run by Mayer. It's the first time I've seen him running behind. He went sort of went short and then he just turned and went in behind. It was a great, great run. He showed his pace down the right-hand side, came on his right foot, and it was just a good block in the end. But that's what Mayer's got to do. He's got to sort of take the game a bit forward, take the game of the scruff and get on the ball, because he will make a difference.
I suppose that was the epitome of what we were just talking about. With QPR all pushed up, there was a little bit more space for Mayer, wasn't there?
That's what the space is today. If he can sort of make them runs in behind and get in behind them, that will sort of make a difference.
Argyle starting to look a lot brighter. Here's Edwards down the right-hand side. He's a bit exposed, one against three, so he cuts back inside to McLeod. Connor Grant, now can he swing it out to the left-hand side to George Cooper? He can. Nicely done by Argyle, who have had some good possession in the last few minutes. Hardy pulls out to the left-hand side to give Cooper an option. Holds it up. Cooper has to come backwards to Watts, but it's still positive from the Pilgrims that they're trying to dictate the flow of this game at the moment, even if they are a goal down to that early goal. Grant has to go back to Michael Cooper. The Pilgrims will build again from the back. Wooten played in the middle of three today. We saw him on the right-hand side of the three a lot last season. Niall Canavan is on the bench today. In fact, I should do the four substitutes. The substitute goalkeeper in the absence of the injured Luke McCormick is Tyler Coombs. Also Niall Canavan, Dom Telford, Clyde Lolos, Adam Randell, Ryan Law and Panucci Kamara on the Argyle bench. The subs for QPR, Todd Kane, Lee Wallace, Olamide Shadipo, Faisal Batache, Liam Kelly, who is the goalkeeper, Paul Smith and Joe Gubbins, if anyone is to be needed. Also worth pointing out, while we're doing bits of housekeeping, that we're 90 minutes and then into penalties today, should it be a draw. At the moment, Argyle would probably take that, being as they are a goal down. But if it is a draw after 90 minutes, straight to the shootout, no messing around with extra time or replays or anything such as that. Rangers try and clear it, not very well from Carroll. Looks frustrated. Now he's got to defend because it's been played through to Hardy, who's got lots of space on the right-hand side. There's a run arriving. It's Mayer. It was just above him. Oh, I'm not quite sure if he'd missed a flight of that or not, because he looked like he ducked as the ball came towards him. I think he must have just lost that in the air.
From here, I think it was a bit too high for him, but that was really good pressing by Argyle on the right-hand side. Created that sort of space for them. Hardy down the right side. He just tried to pick up Mayer sprinting in the box, but I think it was just a little bit too high. But that's better from Argyle. Trying to win the ball high up the pitch themselves gives them that opportunity to create something.
Really pounced on Carroll giving the ball away, and he looked a bit flat-footed there, Carroll, trying to get back into position. But Rangers have managed to get themselves down the right-hand side again. Did that go out? It did, as a very spirited run down the flank from Kakai tried to keep the ball in. He just couldn't quite do it. And Argyle will have a chance to get themselves back on the ball again as we reach the 25-minute mark. It didn't start very well here for Argyle. We worked it out at 67 seconds when Rangers had the ball in the net with a header. And from that point, Queen's Park Rangers dominated the early exchanges. But certainly over the last 10 or 15 minutes, we've seen plenty more from Argyle to show some signs of life and some chances. Rangers have it at the moment in a very, very compact portion of the pitch on their right flank. Amos trying to bring it out of there. He can only do it by going backwards. It'll be Dickey to return it to Amos, right-hand side, looking to go over the top. Thought about it, then went short to Carroll. And now ball to Chair, who's dropped a long way out from the front line to come and get it, to try and create something from deeper. That kind of player floating around all over the place to try and find a way through. In the end, Masterson has to return the ball to his goalkeeper. They're still trying to play it, though. Lumley doing a bit of a 1-2. and then kicking left-footed out onto the left flank. Edwards was pushed in the back as he went to head it for Argyle, so the Pilgrims will have a free kick, which even they take quickly. It is very, very clear that both teams want to play fast, get the ball down and play, isn't it?
Yeah, no, very much so. I think Argyle got maybe take a leaf out of what QPR did a little bit of getting further up the pitch. I can see Ryan Lowe trying to push his back three further up the pitch, but Argyle down the left here.
Mayer comes inside off the left-hand side, tries to shoot, blocked. Forster Nuble, 12 yards out, shoots again, blocked once more. It's still not clear. Hardy, a third block. QPR living on the nerves here. Cooper on his right foot shoots from distance. That one was on target and beat everybody except the goalkeeper, who pouched one shot after another there. First Mayer, then Nuble, then Hardy. It's been, I think that's about five I've counted already, where Rangers have had to put their body on the line. We'll come to it in a second, because now QPR get forward on their left-hand side. Chair just outside the area, comes inside on his right foot. Tries to dummy once, twice, shoots. This time it's an Argyle block and it's Ameson. There's no time to analyse anything here. This is end-to-end. Nuble trying to bring it over the halfway line. He's got barely anyone forward with him, so he goes over to the left to Cooper. Brian alongside me is writing down notes, trying to remember everything that we're going to come back to. And in some ways, he's a little bit relieved to see the flag go up for Hardy as it goes over the top. Right, let's start with the Argyle chances. Three blocks in a row there.
Yeah, no, the QPR have definitely got the blocks in very, very well, defended very well. I think the Argyle, if they can get in that, in the sort of, in their sort of 18-yard box, they will create chances. They've got pace, they've got a bit of sort of guile with Mayer. And I think, you say, three great blocks from QPR, and then on the break, it was Chair down the left-hand side. He seems really, really difficult to mark. He sort of faked to shoot a few times, but then it was a really good block then by Argyle. But yeah, it's definitely end-to-end at the minute.
Played down the left side again here for Rangers. Osai Samuel into the box. Ameson gets a nick. I think that's going to be a corner for the desperate way he tried to keep it in. Smashes it against the netting, protecting the, well, would normally be protecting the fans from the warm-up, but that's not the case today. QPR corner from the left-hand side. This is where the opening goal came from. Argyle will hopefully be a little bit more alert to any danger this time. It looked to go short, QPR, but nothing was on. So now Elias Chair bounces the ball. That's a signal of some sort. There's 5 Rangers players in the 6-yard box around the goalkeeper. Add a couple more Argyle players to that, so it's a very, very, very congested 6-yard box. That's clearly where the ball's going to go, to the far post. Just a little bit high for, I think it was Masterson that was there, and in the end, off the top of his head, out for an Argyle goal kick. Going back to the chances previously, Brian, when Argyle were, you know, one after another having those chances, great defending, you know, putting their bodies on the line for QPR, but you can only do that for so long, can't you? It's going to get through at some point, you would think.
Oh, of course, if you're going to let, you know, people have shots at your goal, you only need maybe deflection and it goes in that way type thing. So yeah, I think Argyle just got to keep persevering. You know, once they get on the front foot and get in behind, they do create chances, so it's about continuing to do that, really.
Down the left hand side with Osai Samuel. Now Chair tries to switch the ball from left to right, heading away, and Mayer tries to bring the ball through. Doesn't quite fall for Hardy. Now QPR look for a 1-2 between Amos and Kakai. Amos comes inside, was hesitating, and as he did, Conor Grant was able to put a tackle in on it and get it away. There'll be a throw-in on the right-hand side, a couple of balls on the pitch. Be taken by Kaká. We're just on the, just coming up to the half an hour mark in this game. Played inside. Still Kaká has it. Not much room, and the referee has seen an infringement. Handball, I think, perhaps as they tried to control it, so Argyle will have a free kick to try and knock it forward. Cooper will take it right from the touchline inside to McLeod. We've seen free kicks such as that almost always go short, but then when it needs to go long, Argyle are going long, and it's a good one over the top to Nuble. QPR defenders bumping into each other, but just about getting there. They'll be playing together for the first time, Dicky and Masterson. It takes a bit of time, doesn't it, as a back line to get used to playing with one another?
Yeah, of course it does. You know that bit of chemistry of playing alongside each other. You need time to do that. I don't think they look that comfortable with the ball going up to Nuble. I think Nuble's caused them a little bit of trouble, really. So. You know, I don't think Argyle are a long ball team whatsoever, but you know, mixing it up might be some sort of way forward today as well.
QPR on the right-hand side. Come back to Kakai. Amos again, just trying to find a way through. Argyle protecting the edge of their box quite well here. Chair has had to drop deep again to try and find something. This time McLeod does a really good job of getting his foot in. And can the Pilgrims break away from this? They'll try. Mayer inside the centre circle, flicks it over the top towards Hardy. Edge of the box. Edwards runs inside him. Has a chance here. Joe Edwards, 1-1. Fantastic breakaway by Argyle. Edwards found the run inside of Ryan Hardy. The ball in front of him was perfect. The finish was excellent. And Argyle are level again.
Yeah, no, great team goal. What a pass by Mayer. Down in the right-hand channel. And for me, I thought Hardy was going to let swing and have a goal himself. But for me, no, really top play. It's just fed it in the left-hand side of it. And then, really, really good finish. Fantastic goal to see.
Let's give a little bit of credit, I think, to Lewis McLeod, because his QPR were trying to get forward, Argyle were protecting really well. Chair had dropped deep to try and do one of the little tricks that we've seen plenty of so far, but McLeod won it, and that's where it broke away, wasn't it?
Yeah, so no, to say, fantastic team goal. Good defensive player by him, great tackle. Pass from Mayer was exquisite.
It really was from the middle. Plenty of credit all around the Argyle team there for that goal. And they get the ball back. No, they don't, not quite. I thought Nublai had just fairly nicked it from Masterson and in a good position, but the referee has given a free kick. So the goal comes just after the half-hour mark. I feel like after a bit of a slow start, Argyle deserved that.
Yeah, they did. They've definitely come into the game. They've grown in the game. They've taken the time. But you can see that going forward, Argyle are a menace. They've got definitely good attributes going forward. And just think that will give them confidence. And if they can maybe get Cooper on the ball a bit more, and definitely when Mayer gets on the ball, he's a threat. So, yeah, that will give them confidence. Good time to score.
It really was. And QPR just look a little bit unsettled by the fact that Argyle have come into this in one or two individual errors, which is not a bad thing to see from our point of view, I suppose. Ball over the top from the goalkeeper to his opposite number there. Lumley long, picked up by Cooper. Aimson on the right-hand side, knocks it towards the right side, but it's a bit of a slice. It goes out of play. Just to touch on what you were just saying about there, about Argyle looking good going forward. It feels like it's a variety as well, doesn't it? Hardy, Nublai, Mayer, Cooper, Edwards. They're different sorts of players. They're going to bring different sorts of threats to QPR. I imagine that's difficult to deal with. Argyle is so not one-dimensional.
Yeah, of course. So if you've got a big man who sort of holds the ball up, you maybe want to sort of stay high up the pitch. But then if you've got somebody like Hardy running in behind, it's a really good sort of mix of attack and sort of prowess. So I think that's a really good mix that they've got going forward. And they've got telephone on the bench as well. So I think, yeah, good options going forward. It's just about, you know, getting those key players in the game, because teams will combat against that and stop that happening.
They've got it again here, Argyle. Picked up on a loose ball from QPR. Mayer, Edwards, Hardy down the right-hand side. Tries to find Nublai. It was just in front of him. I think Cooper will keep this in on the left-hand side, though. Lots of space for him. Keeps it in by the corner flag. Faces up towards Kakai. Is he going to try and take him on? Onto his right foot, holds it up, plays a little ball in towards Watts, has to dig it out from under his feet, and in the end QPR can see that back to their goalkeeper, and it's safe again. But that's the second time in short succession we've seen QPR give the ball away in their own half, and Mayer be the one to be a catalyst to get Argyle forward.
Yeah, I think Argyle are a bit higher up the pitch as well. I don't think they're blessed with lots of pace at the back, and maybe that's the reason why they're a little bit deeper. But when they were able to sort of squeeze up the back three, it enables those players, those creative players, to maybe be more effective in the final third. So hopefully they'll maybe continue to do that a bit more.
You think that's been an adjustment during the game from Ryan
Lowe? Yeah, I could see Ryan Lowe constantly trying to push his back three further up the pitch. But it's hard because QPR have got really, you know, they've got pace up front, so that's a challenge as well, just keeping that balance between both, really.
Manning got a cross in there, and Aimson got it away. Rather shinned it a little bit, but he was in the right position to get the ball away. So it's a throw-in for Queen's Park Rangers on the left-hand side. And not in a hurry to take it. I think they are now the ones that was hoping to slow this down a little bit, get themselves back. Not necessarily in the driving seat, but just to get themselves on top in this game, because Argyle probably had the best of it both up until the goal and since. Here's Chair, left-hand side, not much on for him, very tight again in the restricted part of the pitch. Manning has to come back to Masterson near the halfway line to start things again. He rolls it across the centre circle to Dickey. Hardy tracks back with him. Amos for QPR, right-hand side now, Kakai by the touchline, inside to Amos, and Argyle are happy with where Rangers are at the moment. Everything's been played in front of Argyle, who are shuffling along. Manning being shown the line by Edwards, clipped the ball forward into Ote, but Argyle win it back in towards Nublé, back to goal to Meyer, and then an inventive little flick. I think that was just a pass to space, really, as opposed to anything else, just to keep the ball. Cooper has to pass it to his fellow Cooper in goal. That was George to Michael. McLeod tries to turn 25 yards from his own goal. Free kick is given for a foul on him by, I think it was Carroll. Is that the right decision there, Brian? It was a little bit of a dangerous position to turn.
Yeah, I don't think Cooper should have. You know, Cooper had the ball at his feet, the goalkeeper, and he tried to play a dangerous ball into McLeod when QPR were pressing really tight. I don't think that was the right pass, but I think they got away with one there because I think they're the ones that could be given and may not be given. So Argyle on the left-hand side, good play again.
Lovely one too between Mayer and Hardy, and in the end, Mayer's reverse ball towards Nublé was a little bit in front of the forward, and it's picked up by Lumley. Mayer just looks like he's got the bit between his teeth now, and that he very well, Brian was talking about it all throughout the first 20 minutes or so, that he was going to be Argyle's key while not in the game. Since he has been in the game, everything good from a green perspective has come through Argyle's number 10.
I've been really impressed with Hardy as well. His work rate's been fantastic, and he's running in behind. You know, when Argyle have run in behind, they've created problems. You know, Mayer's done it once, and Hardy's done it three or four times. It's caused problems. So for me, just more of that does turn teams and make them think.
Ball is with Kelwatts on the left-hand side of the back three for Argyle. Gets it back from Michael Cooper, who is happy to play. Brian is right. Before, he was a little bit risky playing the ball into feet, but he certainly is happy with the ball at his feet, Michael Cooper. Now Hardy, what a switch that is from Hardy from one side to another. Plays it out to Edwards, who's got loads of space on the right-hand side. Edwards crosses, looks to pick out a run, doesn't quite fall. He's going to fall to McLeod. Oh, he bobbled and it fell wide. And I think that was a very strange piece of defending from the QPR player who got back there and seemed to not really know. I think it hit him rather than him trying to clear it. It fell to McLeod, but was he not expecting it to come to him? It was a bit of a snatch shot.
I think he had loads of time. He could have took a touch and sort of picked his sort of spot and placed it into the far corner. You know, you don't get chances like that in games very often. Basically, 8 yards out, just free a goal shot, really. I just can't believe he hasn't hit the target there. But good play from Argyle. Good switch from left to right again. You know, good cross as well. So, yeah, better play from Argyle.
Ball from Hardy bringing it out to Edwards was sublime, but when it came out to Edwards, the space he had, yeah, there was just so much. But QPR do seem as if they're committing a lot of men forward, so when Argyle are able to get forward, you know, there are definitely goals in this game. Ryan predicted a 2-1 at the start. We would take that, but there may well be even more in this. This is quite an open fixture. Watts defending in the left-hand side for Argyle, clears it, leaning back, so it ends up bouncing into the block 11 of the Lyndhurst stand, for those of you familiar with it. Throw in taken quickly, but Rangers aren't able to keep it, and it'll be an Argyle throw instead. We're coming up to the last 6 minutes or so of this half as we're here on BBC Radio Devon. It's Plymouth Argyle 1, Queen's Park Rangers 1. It's been an interesting opening 39 minutes of the Argyle season. Wasn't a very good opening 67 seconds because Rangers went ahead, but since then Argyle have come back nicely. Ball over the top there is headed back to his goalkeeper by the Queen's Park Rangers defender, and they will roll it out down the right hand side, playing inside to Dominic Ball, the captain for QPR. He's inside the centre circle now, plays it backwards to Manning, who has to flick it back to the goalkeeper. They're trying to move their players around. You can see here's Carroll now from central midfield come trying to pick it up from deep. It's a good sign for Argyle that Rangers are having to manipulate things a little bit to try and get on the ball, aren't they?
Yeah. It's good to see Edwards sort of matching up down. The wing backs are matching up, because I think that's pushing Argyle up the pitch. But QPR on the attack down the right.
They managed to get it out to Kakai again, just inside the Argyle area. Stabs it in, but it's headed away well by Conor Grant. Argyle with everybody back apart from the two strikers. Once again out to the right hand side. Osman Kakai trying to get another cross in, deflects off of Cooper, and out for a corner. It's been pleasing from a Pilgrim's perspective that we've not seen too much of that since the opening exchanges. Kaká is an attacking right fullback who wants to get forward and get into those areas. This time he did and has managed to force a corner. The chair will wander out there to take it. There's two or three short options. This time there's not a phalanx of players on the six-yard area. This time they're on the penalty spot. There's one, two, three, four of QPR's bigger players matched up by Argyle's. That's presumably the area where it's going to come to. It goes, in fact, over everybody. And now Ameson will try and break away. This is not his natural position, bombing down the right-hand side, but he's done a good job of it so far. Ameson into QPR territory, tries to hook a ball towards Hardy. Picked up by Kakai. And then long away by Carroll. Over the top, picked up by Oti. Chance here. Sorry, it was Osai Samuel, I do beg your pardon. Just inside the area. Onto his left foot. Shoots, gets it across. Never was able to get any power on it. And it was all a little bit ragged as Rangers knocked it back forward again. I think there were some shouts of offside, but in the end, Osai Samuel just not quite able to set himself for that shot.
No, he did look offside to me. But Scott Wooten did really well. I think he stood on his feet, held up and made him sort of shoot, and he sort of dragged the shot wide. But with that long run by Ameson, and he tried like a wonder pass, then he was way out of position. You can see that Ryan Lowe's clapping Scott Wooten for that sort of defensive play. So, yeah, but end to end again.
Yeah, there is definitely, I'm going to say, this could be famous last words, but I think there's definitely plenty more goals in this game. It does feel like both teams are committing themselves forward, which is entertaining to see. Here's McLeod being wrestled to the ground by Tom Carroll. Surely a free kick to Argyle given. And Edwards tries to take it quick. He's stopped from doing so on a couple of occasions. The referee just indicating to the Rangers players that they need to move away. Edwards also leaves it. And now Ameson will take it quickly to Edwards. That was a neat play by Argyle down the right-hand side. Clever, because Edwards has now managed to nick 30, 40 yards. Gets the cross in, headed away. Back in by Connor Grant. And then away, that's good feet from Rangers. It was Carroll, I think it was, that got it away. Amos now caught on the ball by two pilgrims. Now McLeod can't quite get there. Carroll goes over the top. This time it's too heavy, and Michael Cooper will see it into his hands.
Now Edwards had a chance there. Cooper was way free in the left. It was a long pass there, he played, but if he had sort of got his head up, he was sort of in sort of acres of space, and he could have made something happen. But Argyle have enjoyed on the right-hand side, definitely today.
Scott Wooten goes long. Nublé was fouled. Referee gives play on, and in the end, Hardy's touch just lets him down slightly. QPR have it back. Chair back to goal. He's right on the centre circle. Good feet. Gets it out to the right-hand side. Oti looking for some help. Comes inside. He's a little bit all at sea there. Waits and has Kakai to help him. He goes back to ball. And now Carroll. Chair again. He started all that off, and now I think it's notable that we've not seen so much from him over the last little while, but he's influential there, getting it out to Manning. Crosses from deep. It's on target, in fact, but Cooper gets his angles right, pats it down, keeps hold of the ball as we get into the last couple of minutes here. I'll make it just just under 90 seconds remaining of this first half, and I wouldn't see too much in the way of added time. Cooper towards Nublé. It's going to go out for an Argyle throw, I think, on their right-hand side. Edwards, captain, goal scorer. Argyle season last year started with two goals from a wing-back with Callum McFadgen, and it's a wing-back again that started things off today. Good sign, isn't it, when you've got players like that getting on the score sheet as well as the forwards?
Definitely. Yeah, I think that's a sign of a really good team, and you can sort of go places when you've got a team that scores goals from all over the pitch, because then you're not relying on a particular striker if someone gets injured and things like that. So it's really healthy environment when everyone's sort of playing their part and getting goals, really.
Lumley has it for QPR. Just comes out of his area, rolls it to Rob Dickey. They were looking for a ball over the top there. It didn't really come. You can see the Rangers forward line just trying to break on the shoulder, but there was nothing on. So they've returned to their own half again. Back to goal. They have to press it across to Connor Masterson. And now once again, Tom Carroll comes deep, and then with his left foot tries to ping a ball over the top, looking for the run of Manning, who brings it down well on his chest. Gets the cross in, and again, leaning back, it goes out for a goal kick.
Yeah.
And as they say that, 1 minute is indicated by the fourth official, so we're nearly at the end of the first half.
Yeah, it's good play by Manning down the left-hand side for QPR. Fantastic run, great pass. He's took it down his chest, but he's trying to hit the cross first time, and thankfully for Argyle, it's gone sort of over the bar for a goal kick.
Cooper to take it. We can essentially start to wrap up the first half. Is 1-1 a fair reflection of the scoreline, do you think?
I think overall, yes, it is. I think, definitely QPR started the brightest. For the first 20 minutes, they look really lively, really fresh. Argyle looked a little bit leggy, maybe trying to get their second win type thing. Argyle definitely came into it. Free kick hit the post with Cooper. A few great blocks from QPR as well, and a fantastic team goal that we got in the end from Edwards. So yeah, I think one each would be sort of a fair reflection.
There might just be one more twist in this first half. The free kick has been given for a trip on Nubelet. We have literally just a couple of seconds ago gone past the 46-minute mark. So this will be the last action of the first half. Argyle free kick on the right-hand side. McLeod dummies to take it. Cooper does. Swings it in, goes past everybody and in. Now the flag is up. As the referee has given a free kick for offside. I'm not sure whether that didn't go straight in. The referee, I think, has not blown the half-time yet. He's actually going to stop the kick from being taken. Is he having a chat with his linesman about whether anyone had hit this? I'm not sure. I think it's going to be a free kick to Queen's Park Rangers. It is, isn't it? My hopes of it being a goal, I think, are a little bit forlorn. But there is definitely a conversation going on here between referee and assistant. Assistant still has his flag up. Referee with his hand to his head, obviously using the communication system. Just a double check here. The issue was that Cooper's free kick swung in. It may have gone straight in as a couple of Argyle players were going for the ball who were in an offside position. It's definitely been given as a free kick. And I think we'll probably see this through to half-time, then discuss that very briefly.
Yeah.
There is the half-time whistle. So we are in. Plymouth Argyle 1, Queen's Park Rangers 1. But, Brian, an interesting incident there to finish the half off.
Very much so. It's very hard to say, because maybe he gave it for, you know, sort of impeding the sort of goalkeeper's vision or whatever, but hard to say. We're not trying to see on the TV if there's a replay, but there's no replays that we can see at the moment. It's sort of difficult to sort of comment other than that, but, you know, referee's given it a free kick and say, yeah, one each. I think, as I said earlier, it's a fair reflection. Sort of good end to the last 20 minutes for Argyle. Game of two halves, really, the first half.
My understanding of how that law would be interpreted would be that it wouldn't necessarily matter if either of the players that were going for the ball connected with it. It would be more about what they did to the goalkeeper's eye line and sight lines, I think.
Yeah.
Although that law is a little bit vague and does tend to change. But just for a second there, we thought Argyle had gone in at half-time with a goal from George Cooper.
They did look offside as well, so it's just very hard to see from here without seeing a replay. No replays as such at the moment.
Yeah, hopefully we'll be able to see something of that at half-time. So the first half, as we said, began very very well for the visitors. QPR went ahead in the opening 2 minutes. Corner from the left-hand side from Elias Chair was nodded in by left fullback Ryan Manning. And QPR settled in very well to the game, scoring that goal, being 1-0 up and looking very much the better of the two teams. But it didn't take too long for Argyle to get there. They get their play going, get themselves back on the score sheet just after the half-hour mark from their own wing-back, Joe Edwards. And we go in at half-time at a goal apiece, with Argyle probably slightly the happier, would you say? Would you say Ryan Lowe would be slightly the happier of the two managers, Brian?
I think so. I think, you know, because obviously it's the most recent period, so I think they've come into the game, they've taken the time to find their feet. I must say the QPR looked really aggressive, really on the front foot for the first sort of 20 minutes. And they were really pressing Argyle high up the pitch. Obviously, Warburton's obviously watched Argyle the way they play. They like to play from the back, and they wanted to maybe try and win the ball high up the pitch. And that definitely was maybe played in their hands, really, in the first 20 minutes. But started with Cooper's free kicks, hit the post. A few good shots from Argyle, but fantastic blocks. There was one man in particular, put his life on the line and blocked a great shot from McLeod. Overall, you know, Mayers had one exquisite pass that's led to the goal. I think those key players, Mayer and Cooper, if they can get into the game more, I think Argyle can have a really good second half here. But yeah, definitely Argyle ended the game better than they started, definitely.
You feel like the two teams are re-emerging onto the pitch. Argyle have been out to the dressing room area, whereas Rangers have emerged from underneath the Barn Park as measures continue to be separating teams, so everything is as safe as we can possibly do it here at Home Park and indeed elsewhere in the footballing world. It is great to be back with you here on Radio Devon, commentating on some real football once again. And as we've mentioned already, it is such a shame fans are not in the ground, but hopefully that will change as soon as possible. Until that point, we've got you covered here on BBC Radio Devon. So the teams, as I say, are back on the pitch. We'll be kicking off in a minute or two. I don't see any changes of any note. So let's give you the teams before we kick back off again, starting with the Pilgrims. Michael Cooper is in goal. It's a back three of from right to left, Will Ameson, Scott Wootton and Kellen Watts. Joe Edwards is captain and he's a goal scorer, playing from the right wing back position today. Left hand side, George Cooper. In the centre of midfield, the deepest in the three, Lewis McLeod, with in front of him Connor Grant and Danny Mayer, and up front Ryan Hardy and Frank Nuble. Subs yet to be seen for the Pilgrims: Tyler Coombs, Niall Canavan, Dom Telford, Clyde Lolos, Adam Randell, Ryan Law and Panucci Kamara. For Queen's Park Rangers, they have Joe Lumley in goal. Their right back is Osman Kakai, left back and goal scorer for them Ryan Manning, central defensive partnership Rob Dickey and Connor Masterson. They have three playing in midfield. They are Dominic Ball, Luke Amos and Tom Carroll, and then up front a revolving three of Elias Chair, Bright Asai Samuel and Aaron Meadie Oti, as the kickoff goes ahead for the second half. And I scrambled to do my stopwatch, never get that right in the second half, and we're underway once again. As I said, it was an early goal from Ryan Manning that got QPR off to a good start. Joe Edwards with the equaliser, and as we said, just as we were wrapping up at the end of the first half, it felt like Argyle had more chances to have got a second goal, and that will give them confidence, I would think, going into this second half. Brian McGlinchey.
Yeah, hopefully it will. Hopefully the break hasn't sort of given QPR the time to sort of readjust and get themselves the game plan sorted, but QPR got a good chance here.
They have it in the box now and they cut it back, but it was blocked inside the 6-yard area and into the hands of Michael Cooper. But an early warning shot there that Osai Samuel is a threat. He got right to the byline. Argyle dealt with it. This is now Nuble on the centre, halfway line I should say, trying to turn. He was rather outnumbered, but in the end QPR are able to flick the ball forward towards Amos. Cooper comes in off the wing to try and stop him, can't do so. Amos, good feet, and then manages to spread it even further out to the right-hand side. Here is Kakai, as Argyle get past the point where they had conceded in the first half. There's a little minor victory. Kakai plays it down the wing again to Amos, stopped from crossing it by Connor Grant, tries to cut it back. Cooper clears, only as far for the chance from distance for Manning, thinks about shooting, goes out to the left. Sorry, Samuel crosses in, saved at the near post by Cooper, and I think it'll be a corner. It will. No goal so far, but another bright start from QPR.
Yeah, it's a bit of a replica like from the first half, really. Down the left-hand side, QPR seemed dangerous. Really good save by Cooper there. You know, got down to his feet really, really well and put it out for a corner. But yeah, QPR definitely started it brighter in the first couple of minutes for this second half.
I feel like Osai Samuel is there. Every time he's got it so far, he's looked as if he could be dangerous, but he hasn't got on the ball loads of times. But early, twice in this second half, he has done. So that could be a warning sign for the Pilgrims. Okay, we're gathering inside the 6-yard box again. We're actually wrestling into the back of the net at the moment, so the referee is going to have to stop play because it's trying to fit. It's like getting clowns in a mini or something. They're just trying to wrestle everyone into the same part of the pitch. Here it's going to come the corner from the left hand side, clipped in by Chair, flicked on at the near post, blocked by Watts. Well, I thought it was blocked out for a corner, not given. It's given as a goal kick, which is music to my ears. So we'll be. A chance for Argyle to just reset and go from here, because that's been just under 3 minutes of the first half, but it's been spent pretty much all at one end.
Yeah, definitely. So you see that tactic a lot now in a corner where all the players amalgamate around the goalkeeper to put him off, but yeah, thankfully nothing came of that one.
And the delivery, I suppose, has to follow, doesn't it?
Yeah,
they were trying to clip to the near post and flick it on, and it didn't quite come off.
Yeah.
Ball is on the right-hand side for QPR, Kakai over the top. Watts has to try and get there first ahead of OT. Actually, in the end, it doesn't matter because the ball goes out for a goal kick. Going back to the taker of that corner, it was number 10, Elias Chair. We made quite a lot of him in the early part of the first half. He looked like QPR's danger man. Probably would still consider him that, but he faded out of the game a little bit in the first half, which is, do you put that down to, is that to Argyle's credit? They picked him out and managed to subdue him a bit?
I think it's to do with Argyle getting further up the pitch, higher up the pitch, because what he was doing in the first 20 minutes was he was sort of able to find little pockets of space and get on the ball. And what I liked about him as well, when he was making a pass, he didn't admire it. He was going finding more spaces elsewhere. So he did look a danger. But yeah, I think Argyle getting further up the pitch definitely nullified him, stopped that space. And you can see him already trying to get into those little pockets again. So yeah, I think that's more of Argyle getting further up the pitch and definitely stopping that.
Rangers again trying to get down their left-hand side. In the end, the ball came back to Michael Cooper, who once again didn't blast it forward. He passed his way out, but Argyle still have it. This is McLeod in the middle of the park, helped out by Edwards down the right-hand side. I think he was looking for a run he assumed was coming. In the end, Nublé had to react rather than anticipate, and QPR will get it away comfortably. This is a ball for them into Amos, and his ball back to Dickey is a little bit heavy. And now it's QPR's turn just to knock the ball around at the back. They've started the first half the brighter, started the second half the brighter, but definitely the longer that first period went on, Argyle would have been very happy with how they were going. And Brian flagged up Danny Mayer in particular as not being in the game in the early stages, but once he got into it, he was a threat for Argyle. We want to see him on the ball more in this second period too. Kakai crosses from the right-hand side with his left foot. It was a looping ball, which Edwards managed to get to. But Chair picks up the loose one. He's got two around him, but he still has it. Low centre of gravity, great feet, comes between two, gets into the area. This is a danger. Now tries to tee up Amos, but well anticipated by Edwards, who brings it away. Is brought down. A lovely piece of attacking play by Chair, but an even better bit of defensive play by Joe Edwards.
Yeah, no, really good. I think Argyle defended really well. Chair came in, great feet, but they stood up Argyle. He didn't go to ground and just made it really difficult. To be fair, Chair then had to play a square pass, and then Edwards read the second pass then. But a good defender from Argyle. Didn't dive in, just waited and waited and bought the time, and then Argyle, QPR give the ball away. But yeah, definitely Chair looks definitely a threat.
We've mentioned QPR's Chair plenty of times. We ought to give a little mention to Argyle's Chair, the chairman. Had his birthday yesterday. Happy birthday to Simon Hallett. Hopefully his ideal present is a starting victory in the Carabao Cup. We'll see. There's plenty of time to go. It's 1-1 at the moment. Argyle 1, QPR 1. And a reminder that if we are level after 90 minutes, we go straight to penalties. No extra time. QPR looking the most likely so far in the second half, although they've not really had a chance to speak of. They've just had lots of possession and territory. This is Amos to Carroll, flicks it around the corner. This is a shot from distance from Manning, and it's charged away by a good save from Cooper away to his right. On by Ameson, then Edwards as Argyle try and clear, but it's picked up again by Masterson and out for a throw-in to Rangers on the left-hand side.
Yeah, good shot by Manning. It was a difficult one, right, no right to the feet of Cooper, but he done well. Cooper pushed it well wide, and good save.
He's a player, Michael Cooper, that has shown a lot of promise all the way through, even before he made his first team debut. He was being talked up as being one for the future, the way he was thrown in that day at Blackburn and a couple of other times when he's played. But this feels like a new start for him, doesn't it? Starting the game today, he's number one in his squad numbers. Obviously, he's got Luke McCormick for... not just for support, but for competition. It feels like a big season for Michael Cooper.
Yeah, brilliant. To be fair, you know, he's got Lucky there. Well, he's come back. I'm delighted he's come back. You know, a lot of time for Lucky. He's a good friend, and I think he's a good sort of person to sort of help Cooper to develop as a goalkeeper, because I know Luke came into the team as a young lad as well, and he'll know what that's like, and he'll be giving his sort of vital sort of things that he sort of went through when he sort of moved into the team as well. So, yeah, I think that's a really good sort of combination of young and old there in the ranks at Argyle at the minute.
Most definitely. Ball at the back here for Masterson. Plays on the left-hand side. Manning, and now Chair again. Oh, that's the first real instance of him, his touch letting him down as the ball went out underneath his feet for an Argyle throw-in on their right-hand side. They just want to try and get hold of the ball, I'd imagine, here, Argyle. Just keep it for a little bit and to play themselves into the half like they did in the first.
Exactly, I was just going to say, Rob, yeah, exactly. Argyle had that. They had to make a few square passes just to get their eye in, just to get that confidence again. I think the break has done QPR the world of good, and unfortunately, you know, we're maybe having to settle in as well as we could have, really.
Ball is with Kakai here for Rangers. He's going to try and return it to his goalkeeper. And they managed just to keep hold of it at the back under some Argyle pressure. So it's still 1-1 here at Home Park. Argyle falling behind after 67 seconds to a Queen's Park Rangers goal from Ryan Manning. Not picked up from a corner from the left-hand side. But the longer the first half went on, the more Argyle managed to get themselves in it. And they equalised through Joe Edwards just after the half-hour mark. Had other chances too. Plenty of shots blocked. George Cooper hit a post and a free kick that went straight in, but an offside flag went up. We've started the second half. We're about 4 minutes into the second half, but It's really, at the moment, still anybody's game here at Home Park. It's the ball on the right-hand side now with Oti, and it's knocked forward by Kakai. Good defending by Wooten, who managed to force his way in, but fairly, to get hold of the ball. And now McLeod can try and push it down the right. Edwards, a little bit isolated, so comes inside to McLeod, dinks it around the corner. And now Nubley, back to goal. Strong, though, gets himself into a good area on the right-hand side. At the very least, he would look to force a corner, but gets the cross in, and it nearly fell just at the far post. Still in play, George Cooper inside the area, looking to tee someone up. Goes back to Mayer. Will he try and shoot, or will he try and create? Goes inside, shoots, goal! Danny Mayer scores with his right foot, cutting inside. Well, Argyle's most potent creative force, actually only managed one goal last season, but he's opened his account early this year. The ball from the right from Nubley over everybody, kept alive by Cooper. Inside to Mayer. Argyle were patient. He got himself a yard, he fired it low, and the Pilgrims lead.
Yeah, I think my scoreline prediction's going well, 2-1, I said at the start of the game, so hopefully it'll stay like that. But no, Nubley, brilliant, down the right-hand side, really, really strong, aggressive, got the cross in, and then Cooper sort of moved the ball from right to left and just sort of patiently then found Mayer. Then Mayer, great skill, he sort of feinted the shot, then sort of didn't, then he shot with his right foot into the keeper's near post. Really good goal by Argyle.
Didn't have to beat the man, did he? Just had to get himself that half yard and then fire it away. It was a great strike.
He sort of just shifted it to the right and just smashed it into the sort of near post, but keeper no chance as well. So really, really clinical finish.
Big moment in the game for Argyle. It always felt that there were going to be more goals in this game, and it's come for the Pilgrims. We could say possibly against the run of play, QPR have started the second half brightly, but Argyle did do enough in the first half to more than merit being level, so this doesn't feel unfair by any stretch. Chance here for Oti to get QPR back into the game, into the area. Again, Ameson goes to ground in the area, but it's another great tackle. Teed up, edge of the box, flicked in by Carroll. Kelwatch gets something to it. Mightful for Kakai, shoots, it's in. They've responded really quickly of QPR. And after their fullback, the left-back scored in the first half, their right-back has scored in the second. And that is a bit of a killer blow for Argyle. Just over a minute after going in front, they weren't able to clear. A low drive by Osman Kakai. 2-2. Your score prediction lasted about 70 seconds.
Well, there's the kiss of death I've just given Argyle there. But no, it was unfortunate, the kiss of death, you know, in the sense that you're most vulnerable when you sort of score a goal. And that was the case for Argyle. He just didn't clear the lines. And it was a good shot in the end. Cooper got his hands to it. Maybe could have been a bit stronger with his hand, but it was a good finish by QPR in the end. 2-2.
So then, 2-2. They always threatened to be plenty of goals, and we're not quite at the hour mark yet, and we've already had another couple in this second half. So, at 2-2, QPR's 22. Carroll tries to get them going again down the left-hand side, and now it's played through. Asai Samuel gets it across to Cooper, palms it away, but in a good way, gets it away as far as Mayer, who gets it and turns and puts on the afterburners and gets away from Kakai. Outside of the foot into Hardy. Was Mayer fouled off the ball? I think that's what they're shouting for. I'd follow the ball, I have to say. But QPR have it. Carroll. Manning. Back out to the left-hand side. Osai Samuel trying to square up Edwards and then take him on. Bit of a step over. Does go past Edwards. Got the pace to do so. Gets it across the middle. And that goes by everybody. It's going to go out for a throw-in. Goodness me, this is an open game now, Brian McKinchy.
Yeah, it's end-to-end. That was really good play by Samuel down the left-hand side. He just sort of took Edwards on there and sort of left him for dead. Just amazing pace. Perfect pass across the six-yard box and just no one there for QPR to put it in. But I thought Mayer should have had a free kick there. I think Ryan Lowe complained to the fourth official that he should have a free kick just moments before that when he was sort of made a good run down the left-hand side. But yeah, definitely end-to-end.
It sure is. Here the ball is at one end with Queen's Park Rangers goalkeeper Lumley, who plays it out to Carroll, experienced midfielder. He cuts back inside, looks to restart things again with Ryan Manning. Now Dominic Ball, the captain for Rangers, one more on to Dickey, the central defender, but he strides forward. He's about 35 yards out, thought about shooting for a millisecond, but then comes out to a fullback who did score, Kakai. Now Chair, spinning again inside. Carroll tees up Manning. He's already had one shot from distance. This time he clips one in there. Good header by Watts covering the on loan defender. Edwards clears, but not very far. Manning will think about crossing it again. Into Chair. McLeod snapping away at him, stopping him from turning. Osai Samuel down the line towards Carroll, who's made a run from outside to in. And now Osai Samuel, good save from Cooper. Point blank, really good stop. Palmed it up into the air. Ball hasn't left the area yet. Now it does with Edwards. Tries to hoik it over the top, but picked up by Dickey as QPR are a bit unrelenting here. They've got the Pilgrims pinned back. And they're trying to again approach down the left-hand side. Carroll pulling a few strings. Osai Samuel turned by, I think it's Manning. Great save again by Cooper. Really, really well saved down to his left. Spinning, it was an awkward position to do so. He's made a couple of stops. That, for me, was the best of the lot.
Oh, that was fantastic. Cooper has done brilliant there. Just twice he saved Argyle. Really intricate play by QPR. 1-2, he's in and around the box. And Argyle can't sort of compete with that, really. But Cooper's definitely saved them. Two great saves. As you're right, the second one was really strong hand to his left-hand side that stopped that going in. But QPR definitely, since that sort of second goal, they've really upped it.
There's certainly... it's always a funny thing to say about a goalkeeper, because it feels like their primary reason for being. But he is a great shot stopper. I think his best attribute is saving shots. You can always... You'd fancy him in a... Well, if we get to a penalty shootout, I wouldn't mind having him in my goal. You feel like he's got something in him to make a great save. And those moments there were two strong moments for Michael Cooper, keeping Argyle in this. We've got someone down at the moment. It's I'm just trying to see who it is at the moment. It's an injury. So we're going to get a substitute in a second. But at the moment, we're getting some drinks breaks going on. There will be a substitute, which we'll update you on in just a second. But this has been a busy second half already. We are only, let me see, just under 16 minutes into this second half. We've already seen two goals after the 1-1 scoreline at halftime. We have seen Argyle get themselves in front. It was slightly against the run of play, but it was a lovely finish by Danny Mayer after good work by Frank Nuble and George Cooper had teed him up. But Rangers were back level within 2 minutes with their right back Osman Kakai firing in a low drive. This is an open game. It's 2-2 at the moment. There's still half an hour to go, and you feel that there's plenty of goals in this possibly still to come. So we're just trying to see what the substitution is going to be. I don't think it's going to happen quite yet. I think Rangers just assessing their injured player to see the damage there first before they go into making a change. It was Osai Samuel that was down. It's Paul Smith that is looking to come on. Argyle will be able to knock it forward. No sub made yet. Flick on by Nubay. It was just behind Hardy. Didn't quite anticipate the flick there, did the Argyle number 9. And so Rangers will have it again with Carroll. Just feels like the pace of this game has slowed a little bit, which is probably to QPR's benefit. They're just trying to dictate it and just trying to move Argyle around a little bit.
Yeah, I'd say fitness will play into that as well. No first competitive game. None of the pre-season friendlies, but they're not the same.
Down the left-hand side go Rangers again. Osai Samuel, did he keep that in? No, says the assistant. Flag goes up and it will be a goal kick. And I think we will now see the first substitution of the game. Oh, actually, no, Michael Cooper's not going to let them, because he put the ball down and took it very quickly, and the ref is happy for the kick to be taken like that. So Paul Smith has to do some more waiting. McLeod for Argyle, inside the area, inside the centre circle, I should say. Out to the left to Cooper, tries to flick it over the top towards Nuble. Oh, it was nearly there. It was a little floated 9-iron over the top looking for Nuble, but it was... needed a more receptive green, and it just bounced on through to the goalkeeper in the end. But QPR giving away again. Once again, Carroll trying to thread the Ivan needle. Doesn't do so. McLeod does. And so it's Hardy on the right, inside the area. Tries to come inside. Still has it, but it's in the end just a sheer weight of numbers gets it away from him. And Lumley tries to clear away right on his own goal line. All he can do is knock it out for a throw in. Argyle sniffing around there looking for something. We will see the QPR substitute happening now. But before we do that one, there was nearly a chance there for Hardy, Brian.
Yeah, Hardy done well. He sort of moved from right to left, and he just couldn't really get his feet in the right sort of position to get the shot off. Good defender by QPR. But just before that, again, Cooper on the left-hand side. Lovely little chipped, intricate pass in the Nuble. Nuble sort of, I thought he was tripped, to be honest, and I thought maybe the referee was going to give a bit of a penalty there, and Rhino did look for that, but wasn't given. But I think for me, Argyle are just a bit deep again. I just think the three centre-halves have just got to get further up the pitch so Argyle can squeeze and get in the game a bit more. think that's the difference in the really in this the second half compared to the first sort of the last 20 minutes of the first half.
Going down the left hand side here, QPR Argyle clear. In fact, the throw in has been given to the Pilgrims. Yeah, so just to come back onto that, when you're talking about the back three being pushing up, that's giving QPR just that little bit less space to play with, I suppose.
Yeah, it does. But what it also does, it allows your midfielders to squeeze on top of their midfield and doesn't allow them to pick a pass and play the ball behind. It just makes the game a bit more condensed and stops people sort of finding easier passes. So, yeah, it's and you can get further up the pitch to create something yourself. So, for me, it's a bit of bravery because in the sense that you know QPR have got great pace. But you know, if you keep sitting back, you're going to get exposed, and they're going to pick you off, unfortunately.
Substitution was made a few moments ago. Tom Carroll, it was that that came off. Only just signed for QPR, having been a free agent, so maybe the hour or so in his legs was enough for him. He's been replaced by number 38, Paul Smith, who's come on to a sort of right-sided midfield position. Just trying to get a good grasp on exactly what that change has done to the QPR setup. But here's Amos heading the ball forward towards Oti, who holds it up for Ball. And now Kakai again. Cooper trying to stop him from turning and going. He did so, but illegally, according to the referee, just clipping his heels. It feels like Smith has come out further onto this right-hand side. Are they going to a bit more of an orthodox shape here, QPR, with wingers and two forwards?
Yeah, they're playing really... They're going for it, really. They're making Argyle think about the formation. It's really hard to mark when they play like that because you don't know where to go. And it's causing Cooper problems because he's playing as a trying to be an attacking threat, but then he's having to get back in. And he seems sprinting back in now there.
He'll have to try and deal with something now as Oti comes inside. Cooper tries to block him. And in the end, it was a block on inside the six-yard box. I think it was Wooten that got the last touch, but there were several defenders in there. Oti just juggled the ball, hit the ball beyond Cooper, who came out to try and block it. And it was certainly at least one green boot, possibly a couple on the line. That was a little bit last ditch there, Brian. Hearts in the mouth time.
Again, for me, it was unfortunately Cooper. That's not the side of the game that he probably wants to do. Is getting back in. But he was slow getting back in there, and of course, you know, they had a good chance. Argyle. You can see Ryan Lowe and his assistant Schumacher. They're really having a go. The back three really asking them about their formation and different things. So. Trying to figure out what the issue is, but he's not happy with what they're doing at the moment.
Argyle have a free kick just inside QPR's half. George Cooper is going to take it. They obviously want to do it short, but there's not much on, so I think he's going to in the end have to try and clip it in towards Hardy. But that's easy for Masterson to deal with. Amos tries to bring it away but slips. Hardy picks it up 40 yards from goal, trying to keep the ball for Argyle. Goes wide to Edwards in anticipation from Manning to just get a toe in away from Edwards, but Argyle will have a throw in on the right hand side. Again, Edwards just looking for a little bit of support, looking for a bit of help about who he's going to go to. Ends up throwing it back along to Will Ameson, and then one more to Wooten, who looks to dink it in the channel, anticipated by Masterson to stop Hardy from getting there. Hook clearance is not convincing, but it is picked up by Osai Samuel. And then a lovely bit of skill from him, doing it in the right area, plays it through the chair, around the corner to Oti, but he's offside. And he was just looking around the corner. He just wanted that a fraction earlier, didn't he?
Yeah, it was very close, though. You know, it was touch and go whether it was offside for me. But, definitely, you know, Argyle haven't started the second half. You know, they got that goal against run of play. Great individual ability by Mayer. But Argyle just playing a few long balls, aimless long balls, where they just got to keep it on the floor. And just be patient and just build the confidence and feed themselves back into the game because it's not happening at the moment, unfortunately.
No, it's not. And let's have a look at the time in which we've got to go to rectify. We're just about at the halfway point, just gone the halfway point in the second half. So we've got 22 minutes to go, roughly speaking. Cooper just tried to ball up the left-hand side to Nuble, who was held off the ball. Would you anticipate Ryan Lowe looking to his bench and changing something around? He's got a few options.
Yeah, he has got options, but I think this is what it's about. I think you've got to be able to stay in a game, and I think Argyle will learn from this, and if they can stay in this game while QPR on top, it's an important quality you have to do, and you've got to maybe just keep the same sort of setup, because that's the way he wants to play. And if they can do that, that will give them confidence as well. So maybe not just yet. I don't think they're making any changes from what I can see.
Ameson has the ball for Argyle into Wooten. Now Connor Grant right on the centre spot, brings it forward, left-footed to McLeod and now Edwards. This is better for Argyle, keeping it. There's two in the middle to aim at, that's all. Edwards holds it, waits for a run of McLeod, which was tracked. So he goes back to Ameson and then again to Wootton. Into the feet of Mayer, coming deep to create something, and then that quick turn that he's got. Left-hand side, Cooper's on. If he can play it through, so was Nuble. Goodness me, that really was locksmith stuff, trying to thread it through, but it was nearly there. If he'd have got it through, Nuble was in. QPR clear it. Watts deals with it. And now Michael Cooper passes the ball out to Conor Grant.
That's better. You can see even Ryan Lowe's clapping because they're just trying to play the ball from out from the back instead of aimless long ones. So I think, and that created at Mayer a great opportunity, great feet. And he just tried to put it, I have an eagle pass through to Nuble, but it was blocked. I think maybe the pass was out to Cooper, it was a bit wider and might have been a bit better of a pass, but better play by Argyle.
I think more important is getting him in that position, isn't it? We've not seen enough of Mayer in that position in the second half, so
no.
Apart from the goal, obviously, but in terms of that creative position, great to see him in there. And he's just got that little bit of turbo when he gets it and starts to get away from people that's encouraging to see. QPR have the ball at the moment inside the centre circle. Still Argyle 2, QPR 2. As we just enter the last 20 minutes or so of this Carabao Cup tie here on BBC Radio Devon. Left-hand side for QPR. Osai Samuel thinks about coming inside on his right foot. Does so and then cuts back out again. Argyle have got him largely held, but it goes back to Manning. Passes square to Chair. Ball goes under his feet a little, but he keeps hold of it. Now Ball, Amos. Everyone for Argyle back apart from Hardy as Rangers look to try and find a breakthrough. Cross is deflected in the air. Cooper comes for it, claims it really well. Thinks about trying to go forward early to Nuble, but in the end thinks better of it and just takes a step back. He's clearly been encouraged to go short because he's looking for who he can roll it to. And in the end, a clipped kick towards Nuble. Leaps, doesn't win the ball in the air, but Argyle will pick up the bits. Nicely trapped by Conor Grant on his thigh, and then Cooper trying to clip it towards Hardy. A bit more of in hope than anticipation, really, and easily claimed by Joe Lumley in the QPR goal.
Yeah, he thought sort of Hardy was sort of spinning off to his right, Cooper with his left foot. Diagonal pass was just, we weren't the same wavelengths, him and Hardy, but I think that's better. Argyle's starting to make some passes, and that will give him confidence.
Thrown on the right-hand side for Rangers. They've had to go back with it, though. And it's going to be picked up by Nuble, 20 yards out. Loose ball inside the D. Tries to get himself a couple of yards. That's a great block by Masterson. Shot came in from Nuble. It was presented to him on a plate, but it wasn't easy from where he was. Masterson with a really great block. Just making a tackle in the centre. It's going to go out for a Rangers throw.
Yeah, it was good pressure by Mayer on the left-hand side, and they give the ball away. It fell to Nuble. Nuble, he didn't really do any trick or anything. He just sort of moved the ball to the right and tried to get past Maston with pace, and Maston did really, really well and got the block.
Someone's just got the shout there in front of us. I think it's Telford. I think I heard Stephen Schumacher shout Dom up the touchline, and Telford is probably going to be the next Argyle player, or the first Argyle player, to come off the bench in this game. So stay tuned for that in the next couple of minutes. Any thoughts of who that might be for, Brian?
It may be Nuble. For me, I'd keep Hardy on because Hardy looks sharp. He looks fit. For me, maybe look for a bit more pace in there because maybe a bit more of a pacey player might have made that happen, that opportunity there. That's the only option I personally think at the moment, but time will tell.
McLeod with a hopeful ball forward. Lumley came and claimed it right at the edge of his area, and in the end was in a good position to bowl it out to Smith, the substitute. First real chance for him to stretch his legs down the right-hand side, and he plays it down the line into Oti, held up by Wootton. Now it's played square. Chance again for Chair, edge of the box, trying to get it onto his right foot to shoot. Can't quite find it. It goes out to the right-hand side for Smith again. Deflected cross, difficult for Cooper to pick up, but he dealt with it well and then bowls it out to Nuble on the right-hand side as Argyle try and use the space that's been afforded to them by that QPR break. Nuble into the opposition half, down the right-hand side, into Hardy, back to goal inside the area. Nuble now back again on the right-hand side. No one really with him to pass to as QPR gets some numbers back. Nuble gets it across this time. The overhit cross like before is not picked up by anybody and is out for a throw-in. Argyle have the throw. Must have been deflected. So then we'll take a throw in on the left-hand side. Before so, are we going to see the substitute made?
It was a good run by Nuble, but there was no one near him for any sort of support. It was only Hardy that was up that caught up with him, really. But he's just, in the end, he's overhit the cross.
So we get to see the substitution, and indeed QPR are going to make one as well soon. So here's Cooper for Argyle, getting the ball going again on the left-hand side. George Cooper cuts in, and again, not much on for him. Plays it right-footed into the centre circle for Wootton, who tries to play it through to Nuble, who I think would have been offside had he been able to reach the ball that was over his head. Oh, in fact, we're going to get lots of substitutions now. Pens at the ready, everyone. But it's not going to happen quite yet, as this time it's QPR that take a quick goal kick. They're just trying to catch us out on that front today. Masterson for QPR brings it forward from the back, just inside, plenty inside his own half. Has to go back to the goalkeeper here as we're just about to get to the last 15 minutes or so of this game. Argyle 2, QPR 2 in the opening game of the much anticipated 2020-21 season for Plymouth Argyle. Chair flicked over the top, lots of space here for Smith. Is he able to set himself and shoot? He is, and it's in off the post. No, it's bounced off the goal line. I thought it had gone in off the inside of the post, but it went back across, and Wootton and Ameson between them were able to get it away. Smith was in acres of space. He beat the oncoming Michael Cooper, and I wrongly anticipated it was going to go in the corner. Thank goodness I was wrong, but my goodness, what a chance.
Yeah, he did very well. He did everything right. He was really, really unlucky. He just chipped it over Cooper. Cooper came running out, and he's just hit the post, and good defending in the end to get it out for corner. That was a little bit easy how he found that space. Gaping holes in Argyle's back three, unfortunately, there.
Corner from the right-hand side. Chair takes it right-footed into the near post. Good header by Nuble. A forward, but he can be a big presence going back like that as well to help out at the back. Ball is with Amos of QPR. Played out to the right-hand side to Chair, who took the corner. Now gets himself onside, and we'll try and attack Argyle from a different angle. Helped by Smith, tries to play it around the corner for Chair. They should deal with this Argyle, they do. Watt sees the ball out, it's a goal kick, and now we will have the parade of substitutions. So we're going to start, I think, with Argyle. And it's going to be Ryan Hardy, I think, who goes off first of all, replaced by Dom Telford. So it is a change up front.
So I got that one wrong.
It's a 50-50, wasn't it? Heads or tails? What we got for QPR? So it'll be Olamide Shadipo is coming on for Ote up front for QPR. So that's number 18 for 17 there. One assumes a straight swap. And the other QPR sub is going to be Faisal Batachi. And he comes on for the skipper, Dominic Ball. So there's your three changes in quick succession there. Just looking to see if this affects anything too much, but it looks like we're relatively as you were. It's pretty much straight swaps. I didn't see you took the armband for Rangers, for those of you that keep track of that. If I do see, I'll let you know. I think it's Dickie actually at the back. Boys with Nuble back to goal, halfway line for Argyle, played back into McLeod, along the back five to Watts, then George Cooper. Looks to play inside towards Telford, his first touch, and he releases Connor Grant, who takes it lovely with his first touch, plays it in towards Nuble, who finishes off. What a fantastic goal by Argyle, and it's 3-2. Sublime stuff. In it goes to Telford, his first touch releases Connor Grant, who took it in brilliantly. His cross was even better, and then it found Nuble attacking the ball, and he hit the volley beyond the goalkeeper. What a set of changes. What an impact it's all had. And you called Nuble going off. Thank goodness he didn't, Brian. What a goal.
No, good job. I'm not a manager then. I'd have missed out on that. But honestly, that's goal of the season for me. That was just brilliant goal. I've never seen a goal in a long time like that. It was just brilliant football down the left-hand side. And then the cross was inch perfect. And then they take it first time on the stretch, top corner volley. Amazing, brilliant stuff. That will give them amazing confidence. Great goal. If they could hold on to that now, 3-2, brilliant. Really good start of the season.
What a time to score as well. We're just coming up to 33 minutes as QPR get us back underway in the second half, I should say. So that's 78 minutes overall, 12 to go plus any injury time. Argyle back in front. It's a topsy-turvy game. They've been behind, they've been in front, but now they're back in front again. And it's Nuble who's done it. What a fantastic team goal that was from the Pilgrims, getting it out from the back, building their way forward. Excellent to see. Now Rangers are obviously going to throw everything at this now. They're going to come in from the left-hand side, starting with their substitute, Shadipo. What can he create? Tries to cut it back. It's blocked and goes out for a goal kick. In fact, it must have come back off of Shadipo, who has to go and retrieve the ball himself to try and get things going quickly. But actually the player who blocked it, who I think is Joe Edwards, has stayed down. He's now crawling along on all fours, getting himself back going again so he doesn't have to go off for treatment.
You love that as a defender, when you block across and then it ricochets off the attacker and you get a goal kick. It's a perfect ending when you're a defender, that is.
Here's George Cooper, turns back and goes to Kel Watts. And again to Cooper, lovely touch from the Argyle left fullback. Again, QPR putting lots of pressure on Argyle. Need to be careful with their short passing and trying to keep it. Kel Watts has to go long down the line in the end as the ball back to the goalkeeper was blocked off. It's picked up by Kakai. And now Dickey inside to only to find Connor Grant. Now Telford tries to go down the line and his ball deflected off of his own teammate Mayer and out for a throw in. You'd expect, wouldn't you, now Rangers to throw bodies forward, and this could be a bit backs against the wall for the last 10 minutes or so.
Yeah, they're going to push men forward and maybe take risks and take chances. And, you know, with Telford and his pace, maybe that could be an option. Just maybe hit them on the break a little bit. But, they're going to show the defensive qualities Argyle now to see this out.
Smith down the right-hand side, tries to attack beyond Connor Grant. Ball is clipped towards the far post, but it's well judged in the air by Cooper. I'm not sure whether or not Grant just got a little touch on that because the ball seemed to lose a bit of energy in the flight. So
yeah, I think he probably did, to be fair. And that's all you need as a defender sometimes as well, just getting some sort of nick on it to stop take the pace out of the cross, really. But Cooper, you know, I was probably a little bit harsh with it with the second goal for QPR today, but Cooper's been really, really, he's looked really impressive. He's looked really confident, the young lad. His hands look really safe. Yeah, so good for the future, really.
Also happy to play the ball out, as he just did there, helping to keep the ball for Argyle. George Cooper brought to ground as they were trying to keep it. Argyle have just got, that was a foul, but they've just got to watch that a little bit, haven't they? Keeping the ball in their own half, because QPR's pressure, one mistake is going to let them in.
Well, of course, but that, you know, that's the way Ryan Lowe wants to play. He wants them to take balls in dangerous areas, be confident, and take the ball and receive it. So, you know, I don't think he'll want to stop that, but yeah, you've got to be vigilant.
Watts over the top. Dickey pushed Telford off the ball, but Nuble picked up the loose one. His attempt to switch it to the left fell short, and now he, in running back to try and stop things, lunges in, and I think that's the first booking of the game, isn't it? First booking of the season. As Nuble, obviously frustrated. That was just sheer frustration, wasn't it? Just lashing out a little bit.
Yeah, he just tried to make up for the bad pass. I think I watched Ryan Lowe's reaction when he made that pass. He just tried to play a longer pass out to the right, where he could have just played it off in the middle, a safer, simple pass. And that's what you want to do. You want to make safe, simple passes, especially in the last sort of part of the game.
Not really the time for taking chances, is it really?
No.
Rangers kick us off again from that free kick. And they didn't look to lock it in the box. They've still kept it short and tried to keep to the Mark Warburton ethos of passing it about. Here's the substitute, Batachi. Goes square to Chair. And now one more out to another sub, Shadipo. Goes one way, then the other, looking to get a cross in. Manning will do so, left-footed, clips it, falls to Chair. He's got the head on it, but there was no real power. Wasn't a lot of power on the cross, nor the header there. It was difficult for him to impart anything on that, but he was free.
Yeah. I didn't really like what happened there, because Watts and Cooper changed sort of spaces in the box, and you know, Cooper went into more centre-half position, and that's how he got the free header. I don't know why they did that, but you just got to be really, really careful. You know, there's a back three. They've got to stay a bit high up the pitch and stop, you know, maybe things like moving positions when they haven't got the ball is really, really dangerous. So you've got to be really, really careful.
Nuble tries to flick on a goal kick. It bounces around and it's picked up in the centre by Batachi, who spreads it out to the left-hand side. And again, Rangers will try and attack Argyle from that direction. Low ball comes into the middle, but Michael Cooper once again spots the danger, gets on it, leaps on the ball, and for the time being anyway, that particular danger is over. We've got 7 minutes left plus any injury time to be added on. It's just down in front of us, I can see Panucci Kamara, who looks like he might be the latest player to come on and to give us another brand new pilgrim on a day where we've seen a few debuts. Here's George Cooper knocking the ball over the top towards Telford. Can't quite get there, but he's put a lot of hassle around the defender. Oh, the flag is up. I was wondering why there was a whistle had gone, but Telford had come from an offside position to try and hassle Rob Dickey. So QPR can get us underway again with a Free kick along their back line. Long this time by Manning. Any niceties are out of the way. Now they're going to go a bit more direct if they have to. And they do, and they find Shadipo, who's well shepherded, though, by Ameson. It will be a throw-in on the left-hand side for QPR. Batachi trying to wriggle free. Looks look lively, the substitute. But his ball inside is blocked by Edwards. His attempted clearance is a slight slice and finds Kakai, edge of the box of QPR. Now just inside it on the right-hand side, trying to get the cross in. And again, it's a bit of a... wasn't quite set when he crossed it. It's a bit of a slice. It's out for a goal kick.
Yeah, Argyle look a little bit leggy now. And you'd expect that. 10 minutes to go in the first proper game. You've just got to dig deep and hold on and get through this.
Final sub for Argyle. Danny Mayer is coming off with about 5.5 minutes of the 90 to go. He's replaced by Pantucci Kamara. Another midfield player who the Argyle fans will be excited to see. He's not going to have too much time to make an impact today, but he replaces Mayer for the final few minutes. Nublé was backing into the defender as the ball came forward there, so it will be another free kick to QPR. Kamara's pretty much gone into the position where Mayer has vacated, just behind the front two. He comes to Argyle with good reputation, does Kamara. Creative player. We're looking forward to seeing bits from him, but he's not going to be asked to be creative today, is he? He's going to be asked to keep it nice and simple and try and keep Argyle in this. Well, not keep him in this, but keep him in front. Header down from Nublé. Intelligent one, if he meant that, because it goes to Connor Grant. He plays it out to Cooper. He see the grimace on his face as he had to chase that one. That's a long way to chase in the 87th minute, but he got there, crossed it, and then the flick came off of a QPR head. Well picked up by Nubay. Lovely touch just inside the area. Comes back out now. This is Kamara for the first time. Good feet. Holds it. Gives it to Cooper. Now back to Connor Grant. Argyle just need to keep this. Ball into Nubay. Backs in a bit like a basketball player into the key. Goes out from Kamara to Ameson. Lovely stuff from Argyle. Just keeping it. This is all they need to do here. Ameson. Kamara again. Going backwards, but keeping it into Connor Grant. Goes over the top this time. That's probably all he could do from the angle he was at. Rangers will probably see this out for a goal kick. But that was good for a time there for Argyle keeping it. There was not pretty much all Grant could do there, really, wasn't it?
Yeah, there was nothing much on. He had to sort of, if he took a touch on that, he was going to get closed down and potentially lost the ball. So he just sort of played the percentages and found that channel. But good play by Argyle, keeping it simple, passing the ball, let the ball do the work, really. So, yeah, good play.
It's with Manning on the left-hand side of the defence for Queen's Park Rangers. And now Masterson and now Dickey, they're keeping it at Rangers, trying to loosen Argyle up, just find something to unlock the Pilgrims. Nublé now have the chase back as Amos tries to break forward, but they're not going anywhere. Argyle, all 11 players in their own half, shuffling along, just trying to stop the space. Chair has come from up front to deep again to try and find something where he can get the ball and be that creative player to get through Argyle. It's not happening just yet. Telford now chasing back like a dog in midfield, just trying to get hold of the ball. Well, not necessarily get hold of the ball, but just put enough pressure on the Rangers so they can't go anywhere. And over that whole period, all they've done is advance to just outside the centre circle, and now they give it away. And Cooper does enough outside his defender, goes up the line to Nublé. Kamara's behind him if he can find him. Goes safer to Cooper, who tries to go long, but it's smashed off of Patachi. And Ryan Lowe wasn't thrilled about the attempted Hollywood pass rather than just trying to keep it. Into the feet now of Osai Samuel, who's become a bit more of a peripheral figure since he came inside, which is to Argyle's benefit. Here's Kamara taking it off of McLeod, getting over the halfway line for the Pilgrims as precious seconds slip away. And the Pilgrims are happy to keep it. Now Ameson will go all the way back to Michael Cooper. Takes a touch. He's not under any pressure yet. Now he looks to go long. Telford is not really a target man, so he's not going to win that in the air, but it's all about picking up the bits, and they have done. Connor Grant inside the centre circle to Cooper. Grant turns again back to Watts. This is going to go once again back to Michael Cooper as we hit the 88th minute of this game. 2 minutes to go, plus anything that is added on. Long towards Nublé again, but once again the Pilgrims pick up the loose one and pick up a throw, and they're doing a good job here.
They are, and what's really impressive, Argyle's picking up all the second balls. So the last 5 minutes, any second ball that's dropped, Argyle's been there, and that's really, really crucial. And then they're just keeping that ball, keeping it really simple, and it's not allowing QPR to build any momentum, get any passes together to give them any sort of chances of putting a sort of an attack together. But hopefully they can see this out. Really, really good sort of overall performance in the end.
Throwing is taken down the line by Ryan Law, who, while Brian was talking there, came on as a substitute for George Cooper. So we'll see Ryan Law, who spent last season on loan at Truro with Paul Watton. Going to be given some chances this season to shine on the left-hand side. He's a left-back very confident on the ball. He took that throw, but it's now with his opposite wing-back, Joe Edwards, who passes it back to Will Ameson into the final minute now. McLeod back to Wooten. He'll probably look to go into the right channel, tries to dig a ball out towards Telford. He was clattered by a couple, fairly, says the referee, and it'll end up back with Lumley, the Rangers keeper. Still there trying to pass it out though, Rangers, no knocking it forward, although I suppose they've not exactly got big men up front to aim at, so they're trying to stick to their philosophy. But it's not got them out of their half yet with 30 seconds left of the 90. Looking to see the fourth official below us to see what he comes up with in terms of minutes to be added on. Played long, but easily picked up by Ameson there. Argyle will be happy if Rangers try and go long like that. Edwards down the line to Telford. Holds it up, goes down. Intelligent play by Telford using his body.
Yeah, good play by Edwards and Telford. Yeah, Edwards didn't just go for a long ball. He just kept it, and they played it into Telford's feet. And Telford, very, very smart play. Bought himself a free kick. And that sort of crucial time also ebb away now.
5 minutes of stoppage time has been indicated during that period where Telford was just getting to his feet and Argyle getting set to take a free kick. So we're going to have an extra 5 minutes added on that the Pilgrims need to see out. It would be the third successive season that Argyle would get to the second round of this trophy that they don't always do all that well in. And it would be an interesting scout, but it's not happened yet. They're still going to see out another 4 minutes or so. And this is Kamara having to go a long way backwards, and it's a somewhat risky ball back to Cooper, but it was well executed, and Cooper's clearance goes deep into the QPR half. Telford challenges, doesn't win it, and the loose ball falls to Smith, who has to cut back on the halfway line to Kakai. And again, Argyle well in shape enough to force Rangers back. They try and shift it to the left-hand side to attack via Manning, who got their first goal. Can you create something in the final minutes as well? Onto the left-hand touchline. Shadipo attacks at Argyle, twists Edwards this way and that, but in the end his cross hit the back of the Argyle retreating number 8. Back in again by Shadipo, well delivered to the edge of the 6-yard box, it's gone wide, it's a corner. I don't know whether Asai Samuel got anything on that at all. It certainly hit off a defender and went wide. It was a good ball in, it was dangerous.
Yeah, fantastic cross in, and Samuel, you know, maybe should have done better there. That's probably their only chance really in the last 15 minutes or so. They've not really created any substance, but
short corner here. Played into the woods and near post, shot comes in, there's lots of tangled legs around, it's not been properly cleared yet. It's going to go to the right hand side where Chair stops it, looks to try and dink it back in, thought about it and then didn't. Outside him goes Smith, there's the clipped cross, the header is clear. The header from Ameson went against the Queen's Park Rangers player and was on target, but Cooper dived on it and saved it. That was nearly an extraordinary goal to end things.
Yeah, Argyle fell asleep in the corner there. Again, you can see Randall was really, really unimpressed by that, but they got away with that in the end. But yeah, 2-3 minutes to go.
Yes, we've just gone past the second minute of the 5 to be added on, so still 3 minutes to see out, and that will feel like a lifetime if Argyle don't get hold of it. But they have got hold of it now. Watts gets it forward. That was deflected, was it? No, it wasn't. It's just out straight for a throw in. Actually, it was deflected. I thought it was, and the referee has overruled his assistant. So that's good news for the Pilgrims, because Law will be able to take the throw in. You would think down the line is the option, wouldn't you, to try and press QPR back?
Definitely, or just feet and back in and just keep the ball.
Law throws towards Nublé down the line. Everyone misses it, but that's okay for Argyle. Telford pressure. They're going to try and see this out here, Rangers, but they're in a bit of a tight spot. In the end, Dickey manages to clear towards the halfway line. Asai Samuel didn't win it. Wooten tried to clear, but it was deflected down. Asai Samuel picks up the loose one, tries to play it to his left, and the runner comes through, but it's a good bit of goalkeeping from Michael Cooper off of his line as Olamide Shadipo was flying through on it. And another Slight worry for Argyle is picked up. Asai Samuel looked as if he was trying to thread Shadipu through, but it wasn't quite far enough in front of him, was it, to get the right position on the run.
But again, Cooper read the situation really well. He was on his front foot, he was off his line, and he was able to sort of be a sweeper there and pick that up, so really good play by him.
Kick goes straight out for another throw-in. I make it just under 30 seconds remaining of the 5 minutes that we were seeing being added on. QPR throw it backwards. They're going to have to go all the way back to their goalkeeper, so seconds are ticking away. Are they going to go long? Are they still going to try and thread it? They're going to hit a channel, I think. Lumley looks to go left. Doesn't get much on it. Edwards was able to chest it down for Argyle, and he leaves it to Kamaru. Cuts inside, keeps it, then threads to Edwards. Again, Argyle just trying to keep the ball outstretched, but they do. McLeod, Ameson, tries to fiddle it down the line, but it didn't quite work. QPR have it. Amos, Patachi over the top. Wouldn't read it. Brought it down. Oh, didn't quite keep it in, I don't think. So it will be a QPR throw on the left-hand side as we enter the final. Well, I've got just over 30 seconds left on my watch.
You've got to use that one.
This could be the final chance here.
This surely is going to be it. QPR will take the throw in. One last ditch knock into the area, you would think. They're still playing around with it, though. They're knocking it square along the back. Now it's Amos. They're not getting it in there. They've dwelt on it. And now Kamara. Oh, Argyle nearly broke away and completely sealed it. But in the end, Rangers have got it. Down the right-hand side, Smith needs to get it into the box. Comes onto his left foot. Is he going to shoot? He does. It was the wrong option. And it's going to trickle away. It's going to be a goal kick. And that might be it.
Yeah. Nearly Argyle caught them on the break there. Just couldn't get the pass away. But, yeah, the shot there by Smith. Gloriously, horribly wide. And I think you're right. I think that's it. Really good afternoon for Argyle.
We'll judge it when we hear the actual whistle. I don't want to go too prematurely, but I think that will be it. Certainly the 5 minutes were up, unless the referee saw fit to add anything else on during that injury time. I think Smith's teammates will be a bit frustrated there. He didn't try and play one of them in. The ball goes forward from Cooper, and the whistle blows. It is a successful start to the season here at Home Park. Well, there was no one here to see it, but it doesn't mean it wasn't the thrilling game. What a great start to the season. Argyle going a goal down, getting it level, 2-1 up, 2-2, and then a spectacular winning goal from Frank Nubley to give Argyle the win. An exciting afternoon, and whenever you get an exciting game, you want to come out on the right side of it, of course, Brian. It's no fun having a great game and losing, but
no.
Argyle will be delighted with the advancing to the next round, but also I would imagine the way that they have played against a senior opposition today.
Yeah, you should be very impressed. There's different stages of that game where they played really, really well and they were on the front foot. There was different stages where they were on the back foot and they had to dig in and keep going. Have to say, the three goals of the Argyle scored this afternoon were of real top quality. Real, you know, the world championship level. They've honestly a really good standard of goals. The third goal for me, if we can see it, anyone can see it, the standard was probably could be up for goal of the season. Really, it was really, really great team goal. And then the finish was just sublime. Really, top corner on the volley on the stretch from Nubley. That will give him great confidence. For me, really good afternoon. I thought from start to finish, everyone, you know, really put a big shift in. Cooper in goal was brilliant as well. You can see Reese giving him a good sort of pat on the back there. He did really, really impressive as well. So, yeah, really good afternoon.
You feel that all three of the goals, from Argyle's perspective, well taken, but you would also give a lot of credit to two or three other people, wouldn't you, in the build-up, that it was, you know, someone winning a tackle deep and then Argyle pushing forward, or, you know, the touch and cross from Conor Grant for the last one was absolutely perfect, wasn't it? Ryan Lowe will be delighted that so many people have played a part in all of those goals. He'll be able to give a little, you know, merit mark to so many people.
Yeah, I get what you're saying. And that's what's impressive. You see goals that are maybe great wonder strikes from 20, 30 yards or whatever, but all three goals were of really good play. You know, remember the first one, really intricate pass, long pass from Mayer. They found Hardy and he put in Edwards, and it was a really good finish. Yeah, and the second goal, Mayer really nipped him his right foot and great finish. But then the third one, to say. So, yeah, you're right. You know, really good team goals and great finishes as well to top it off. So everyone will benefit from that. Really good confidence for the first game of the season.
And it still feels like there's it's a bit of a learning, still a learning situation for Ryan Lowe. As early as we are in the season with his squad, there was certain amounts of this that felt like a pre-season game in the build-up. It certainly didn't play out that way. It was a very competitive fixture, but I'm not suggesting that will be his final 11 by any stretch. He's still learning about what his best team is going to be, and he'll continue to into the season.
Yeah. I don't think you have a nucleus of a team that you want to rely on, but I think it's about a squad these days, isn't it? It's about everyone playing their part. And you learn about your players every day, every training session, different things of what happens throughout the season. And for me, you'll have a good idea as to who the nucleus is. But no, for me, it's great to see your young fullback coming on as well, Ryan Law as well. It gives people opportunities. It gives the whole club that sort of great sort of profile in the sense that you'll get a chance here if you're a good player. So for me, I think since Ryan Law's come in, he's made a difference, and he's definitely got a different style of football, which is really, really impressive.
Well, it's been a good afternoon here to begin the season for Plymouth Argyle. It was a topsy-turvy game, lots of goals, lots of action. But in the end, they have seen it out and won 3-2 to progress to the second round of the Carabao Cup.